Hello everyone, now in this video I am going to talk about the booth encoding example. I have taken an example that x is equals to 0001, and in the decimal form it will be 25, and x will be my multiplicand and y will be my multiplier. The main motive of the booth encoding is to reduce the number of partial products. Okay, so what will be the number of partial products? The partial products will be calculated using the formula n/2+1, and n will be the number of bits of the multiplier. In this scenario, I have the n is equals to 6, as you can see, and when we put n is equals to 6, the 6/2 will be 3, and 3+1 will be equals to 4. Okay. Before going to forward, I would like to tell about the table of the booth encoding table that will be showing in this page. So this is the table for the booth encoding that I will be referring when I am solving the multiplication using the booth encoding principle. Now I have the inputs here, and here the partial products. Okay, when I have to make a group of 3 bits, so here when we have a 3 bits is equals to 000, so the partial product will be 0. When we have the 001, the partial product will be x, and when I have the 010, that also x, I have already told you that it will become multiplicand. Okay, when we have 011, it will be 2x, and the same way it will goes on, and I have to consider it this table when I am solving the booth example using the booth encoding principle. Now let's come to the booth encoding example. So I have considered the y, and what will be the basic thing I need to cover here? That y is equals to, as you know, 100011. So we have 100011. In this, I have to add the thing that I have to append the bits. How can I append the bits? I need to append the bits before the LSB. Okay. I can say that the before the or after the MS, after the LSB, and the before the MSB. I have to append 2 zeros before the MSB, and I have to append 1 zero after the LSB. So I have appended this, and now I need to make a group of 3 bits. Now that's, I will start from the MSB side, that I have to make a group of 3 bits, that 001. I have made the 3 group of bits, as you can see here, that I have made 3 groups, and another, here is another group, and here another group, and there here. So in total I have the 4 groups. So I will numbering the partial products from the LSB side. So the first partial product, that I will be called as the PP0, and here's PP1, PP2, and PP3. So when I'm talking about the PP0, that's the number, that is the partial product, the zeroth position, that will be 110. So at the 110, as you can refer the table I have already shown to you, that as you can see, I got the 110. Okay, so in the 110, I have 110 here, and it will be minus x. So I will write as minus x. Okay, in the same way, the I'm talking about the PP1, I will have the PP1 is equals to PP1 is equals to will be 011. Okay, in the 011, it will be equal to 2x, and in PP2 it will be equal to minus 2x. In PP3, it will be equal to x. Okay, this is the basic thing I'm covering here. As you can easily write by considering the previous table I have already shown to you. Now after this, what will be the y? The y will be equal to 1 minus 2, 2 and minus 1. And I have written in by considering the base 4th. So by I have to mention the 4 here because it is the base 4. So this is the basic thing I am covering here. Now let's say I have to transform from the base 4 from the base 4 to the decimal, to the decimal. So what I have to done that I will be y is equals to 4 cube into 1 plus 4 square into minus 2 plus 4 raised to the power 1 into 2 and plus 4 raised to the power 0 into minus 1. Okay, and now using this you can calculate this. Okay, and I will be getting the 39 in the base 10, that is the decimal form. Now I need to multiply the x and y, and the product will be z. So how can I do this? I will be doing using the partial products that I have clearly calculated here. So what I'm going to do? I'm going to do is that firstly the partial products will be pp0, and the pp0 will be equal to minus of x. That means I need to complement the x, that is the multiplicand. So what is my x? X is mine. X is here. So x is equal to 0, double 1, double 0, 1. And I need to complement it. So what will be the complement? You know about the how to take the 2's complement. So the same thing happens here. So I have taken the complement. So the complement will be 1, 0, 0, triple 1. Okay, and in this scenario I need to append the sign bit, so I'm going to take the sign bit extension. So a 1 1, so the MSP will be 1, so sign bit will be 1, so sign bit will need to append. Sign bit will be appended 1 1 1 1 1 1 1. Okay, so in the next PP1. So what is my PP1? PP1 will be 2x. Okay, that means I need to shift the multiplicand x by 2 bits. So I will be shifting the multiplicand by 2 bits, and whenever I have the 2x, I need to add the 0 at the MSP. So I need, when I have 2x, I need to add the 0 before the LSP. Okay, 1 1 0 0. Okay, now the 2x will be equal to 0 1 0 0 1 1 0. Okay, and I need to append the sign extension. So I am appending this. In the same way I will have the PP2. So the PP2 will be equal to minus of 2x. So the minus of 2x will be equal to, so I need to append the complement of the x by 2 bits. Clear? So that will be equal to, and the same thing will be goes on, that adding 0 before after the LSP. So it will be 0 1 1 1 0 0 1, and I need to add the sign extension, so I will be adding, and the PP3 will be equal to x. So what is the x? You know about the x, that x is equals to 011001. So the I will be writing this. So it will be 100110. Okay, and I need to add the sine extension here. And after that, I'm adding these things. After the addition, it will be this, which is equals to 975 in the decimal form. So this is the basic example for the Booth encoding, and I hope it will be helpful to you. And thank you so much for the watching.